Thank you very much. Also from my side, a warm welcome. And as already said by my colleague here, I would like to talk a bit about the first-person field-to-cloud workflow, what it is. You will listen and learn about it in a minute. And it covers also our Leica BLK2GO Pulse mobile first-person laser scanner and in combination with our great cloud platform, Reality Cloud Studio. Before I jump into the details, however, I would like to give a broad overview about the general reality capture workflow, also relevant for the mobile mapping, where it all starts with data capturing. And for this, at Hexagon, at Leica, we have a couple of great solutions, a wide range portfolio covering both mobile laser scanners as well as static laser scanners, depending on your needs of the application. However, with capturing alone, it's not enough. Typically, it follows by a preparation step, which can be done by cleaning data, registering data, any manipulation of your data that you captured. Also there, we offer quite some nice tools to be efficient and very productive. Very famous are Cyclone software suite. After that, it continues, because then you have to manage the data. I mean, mobile mapping, it's a lot of data, quickly captured, laser points, and also images, and you have to manage this kind of data. Also there, you want to be efficient, using the right file formats and sharing quickly. As you know, with Hexagon, we also have discovered and can have the right data file for your needs. Finally, you would like to create your deliverable, huh? You need then to create, for example, a texturized mesh, a plan. It's then the last step, what you need to cover to make your customers happy. And you know, also there, we have our own solutions, plenty of those, depending what you need to do. But at the same time, also, we nicely integrate to third-party solutions. Today, I'm happy to introduce you the BLK2GO Pulse as another tool in our basket of capturing. It's a mobile handheld first-person laser scanner, which works with all of those softwares that I mentioned, but especially highlighting in combination with Reality Cloud Studio, a cloud platform which covers basically all those three steps in one big basket. And as you might already imagine, Reality Cloud Studio is not only working with the BLK2GO Pulse, but can also make use of the data from our other products that we have in the field. So today, I would really go into this combination about BLK2GO Pulse and Reality Cloud Studio, talk about first-person scanning, and then Reality Cloud Studio being a reality drive, a collaboration space, and then also our Cloud Studio. Starting with data capturing and the BLK2GO Pulse, it's a completely new technology what we are using here. It's not dual-axis LiDAR scanner, as we have seen from the presentations before, so there's no rotation parts inside, which sends out the laser signal. We are making use here of solid-state time-of-flight cameras, which we developed and collaborated on together with Sony. And this allows us a complete new technology to capture the 3D environment. However, it's not only this new sensor that we are using, it's more, because we integrate it nicely, because we make the pulse technology happen. And the pulse technology is where we then fusion this time of flight, this dual time of flight, together with our proven Grand Slam, so that we can map the world around us in real time, and this in full colors. And what this allows us also is to avoid any post-processing. So we can do post-processing, but it's not mandatory, as we do it everything in real time as you walk mobile through space. And this leads us to what we call first-person scanning as a very new way of capturing the reality. We call it the most intuitive way, because what is more intuitive than what you see with your human eyes? So this means our field of view of how we perceive the environment, it's not 360 degrees. That's too much information to easily digest. It's really tailored to what we see. So we have here a directed field of view of around 210 degrees times 85. Also, when you look around, you get the information instantly. There is no delay. And also, this delay we realized with our first-person scanning device. And finally, look around you. The world is colorful. And also, this colorization we bring into the solution in real time. So by making first-person scanners, we can now perform first-person scanning as a brand new way of capturing, really capture what you need and capture what you see to make the whole workflow very efficient. A quick look into the details shows that it's a very small and lightweight device. We are talking here about just 850 grams, so clearly less than 1 kilogram. Everyone can carry it around. And nonetheless, it's really a complex device in terms of technology. We have covered a couple of sensors, cameras, IMUs, dual time of flight, and still easy and lightweight for the operation so that you don't have to worry about it. The system takes over all the heavy lifting. First-person scanning comes then to also the fact that I want to see the data. And for this, as the sensor doesn't have any display, you can simply put your smartphone on it, and it will act like a display. And this allows that what I see, what the sensor sees, is nicely in line with my smartphone. So very intuitively and nicely in its operation. So talking about the smartphone, we have an own app created, which we call BLK Live app, and which does more than just giving us the nice data. It combines 2D view, 3D view, and also first-person scanning view in real time, so that you see the colorized point cloud. Also, you can remotely control your scanner. We have basic data management, and it shows us the feedback of the smart sensor, because the smart sensor, it's intelligent as it sees if the operator is doing something not correctly. Maybe he's walking too fast, and then a message appears to walk a bit slower. So the system guides you in this capturing process. And finally, as the data gets processed in real time, you can quickly export directly from the app as a colorized E57 and via various formats as well. And the app is available for iOS and Android. Now, we are also able to upload the data easily and conveniently from the field into Reality Cloud Studio. So at the push of a button, you can select the data you want to upload. So as you see here, different export functions. One of those is Reality Cloud Studio upload. And then the data will use the internet information, either Wi-Fi or mobile data, to upload and sync to the cloud. So you just select the folder in Reality Cloud Studio, and then the data will be uploaded directly from the field in a very quick and easy way, so that immediately your colleagues and stakeholders can make use of it. And then in Reality Cloud Studio, of course, it acts like a database, because you can consume a lot of data, you can upload a lot of data of various devices, and you have to store this data. So this is realized with Reality Cloud Studio. You can give access and user rights, so that you ensure that whoever wants to get access to the data, that this is the right person. You can give different roles, who has edit rights, who has viewing rights, and you can also share the data with people who are not yet registered with Reality Cloud Studio to visualize the data. It's more, it's also data and file management, because mobile mapping, it's also big data, it's a lot of data, and you want to efficiently find your data, the right data, so we use latest and greatest tools to ensure this, that you quickly find the right data. It's also a lot about automation. So mobile mapping, it can consume a lot of data, and not only one walk might be required, but a couple of walks. And typically, registration is a manual process, but we fully automated it in Reality Cloud Studio by making sure we use the Pano images and the point cloud to register easily and accurately. It goes further. It's a visualization tool as well. So you can create nice virtual tours. You can measure directly in the data. You can look on this in 3D space. You can annotate. So everything what you could imagine, we have it already covered nicely in Reality Cloud Studio. Collaboration, because many stakeholders might want and might need to work on this. So you can together work on your ground truth. You can easily share information, as you know it also from other tools of Office 360 and so on. So this is now also in the spatial world possible with Reality Cloud Studio. And finally, it comes to the deliberation part, where we also can create, at the push of a button, automatically from a colorized point cloud, a texturized mesh with all our sensors, and also BLK2GO Pulse is covered nicely. At the end of this, you want to export the data. As said, we have you covered with various formats depending on what your needs are, but we also can stream the data directly into our Cyclone platform, and we start with Cyclone 3DR. So we open Cyclone 3DR and we connect to the cloud to stream there the data from. This, I think, was the last slide. Now, as an overview, once more, the first-person scanning field-to-cloud workflow is a very intuitive, quick and easy, but yet powerful way of capturing data and creating deliverables. If you want to know more, I would like to invite you to come by, visit us. We have two booths. You find the information here and really have a look on the first-person scanning experience. You need to see it that you understand how great it is. And like this, I would like to thank you and wish you a successful last day at the Intergeo.